Beep, 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 boop, bop, 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 beep, 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 beep.
I'm gonna start by connecting the transistor to the breadboard. So here are my EC547 transistors. And I'm gonna connect the emitters of the transistors to the negative rail of the breadboard. So I'm using black jumper wire. I will connect it to the emitter of the transistor and the other side to the ground. Next, I will connect the collector of the first transistor to the base of second transistor. Perfect. Now I'm going to use my 220 ohm resistor and I will connect it to the collector of the second transistor and the other side to a blank spot on breadboard. Here is my blue LED. I'm gonna connect the anode, which is the positive pole of the LED, to the positive rail of the breadboard, and the cathode to the other side of the resistor. Next, I'm going to use my 1 mega ohm resistor, and I will connect it to the base of the first transistor and to the positive rail of the breadboard. Hundred kilo ohm resistor, I will connect it to the collector of first transistor and to the positive rail of the breadboard. Looks good. Now it's time to connect our capacitor. So I'm using 100 microfarad capacitor. I'm gonna connect the cathode to the base of the first transistor and the anode will be connected to a blank spot on breadboard. I'm gonna connect the anode of the capacitor to the positive rail of the breadboard via my 4.7 kilo ohm resistor. So one of the leads goes to the power and the other one to the anode of the capacitor. Let's connect our condenser microphone to the breadboard. Here is my microphone, which has two poles. The red one is the positive, which will be connected to the anode of the capacitor. And the other pole, which is negative, will be connected to the ground. Last thing we need to do is to connect our power supply to the breadboard, and we will be done. So I'm going to connect the power supply to the circuit. I have 9 volts coming into the circuit, and let's see if the circuit works. So beep 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 beep. Yeah, as you can see, as I speak through the microphone, the LED will be turned on. And let me just bring it to the view. Okay, here's my condenser mic. Beep 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 boop bop 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 beep 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 beep. Let me do a clap. Unlike other YouTube channels, which they build electronic projects on breadboard, but at the end, they give no explanation, I'm gonna explain how the circuit works. So initially, when the circuit is powered on, both of the transistors are in inactive states. It means that no current flows through them. Our capacitor is also uncharged. When a sound or clap is detected by the microphone, a small electrical signal will be generated. This signal is then coupled through the 100 microfarad capacitor to the base of the first transistor. The amplified signal at the collector of the first transistor is then coupled to the base of the second transistor, why this yellow jumper wire? If the amplified sound signal is strong enough, the second transistor starts conducting current from its collector to its emitter. And as you have seen, we have connected blue LED and a load resistor to the collector of the second transistor. So if current flows through the collector and to the emitter of the second transistor, then our LED at the end will be turned on. That's how the circuit works. I hope you enjoyed the video. Please let me know in the comments if you have any inquiries about the circuit diagram, or the working principle of the circuit. And I hope that you can do this on your own. I would be very happy to see that some of the guys which viewed my YouTube videos, they are able to build these projects on their own. Thanks, and have a good day.